my name is Iris France, and today we're going to talk about the entry game. So in this game, we have two players, the new firm, I call that in, and the existing monopoly, I call that in. And this game is sequential, meaning we have a first mover and a second mover. So the first mover is the new firm. The new firm is going to choose whether it's going to enter this market or not. So we have existing monopoly in the market, and the new firm is going to choose whether to stay out of the market or to enter the market. And if the new firm chooses to stay out, then the game ends and the payoffs are realized. If the new firm chooses to enter, then the monopoly can choose to play nice or to play mean. So mean is that if the monopoly chooses to start a price war and cut the price a lot, then both the monopoly and the new firm are going to suffer a big loss. But the monopoly can also play nice, meaning not cutting the price too much, so they can both share the market share. So you can see if the new firm chooses to stay out, by the way, the strategy for the new firm is to stay out or to enter, and the strategy of the monopoly is to choose to play mean or play nice. And if the new firm chooses to stay out, then the new firm is going to get nothing because we stay out of the market, we don't make any money. And the existing monopoly is going to get $10 million. But if the new firm chooses to enter, then we're at this node. If the monopoly chooses to play mean, cutting the price and start a price war, then the new firm is going to suffer a $2 million loss, and the existing monopoly is going to suffer a $1 million loss. But if the existing monopoly chooses to play nice, then the new firm can enjoy a $2 million reward, and the existing monopoly is going to get $5 million. So how do we solve this game? How do we solve for Nash equilibrium? So we can put this game into a matrix. So we have the new firm is the role player, and the existing monopoly is the column player. So the new firm can choose to stay out or to enter, and the monopoly can choose to play mean or play nice. So we can see if the new firm chooses to stay out, then we know the new firm gets 0 and the monopoly gets 10. So that will be 0, 10. And if the new firm chooses to enter and monopoly plays mean, then the new firm suffers $2 million loss and the monopoly suffers a $1 million loss. But if the monopoly chooses to play nice, then the new firm is going to get $2 million profit and the monopoly will get $5 million profit. So how do we solve for this game? So we use the best response, like what I talked about in the previous video. So we can say, hey, given that the monopoly chooses to play mean, what should the new firm do? So given that the monopoly chooses to play mean, then we're looking at the left column. So the new firm will be like, if I stay out, then there'll be nothing. I will just get zero profit. But if I enter, I'm going to suffer $2 million loss, and 0 is better than negative 2. So given that the monopoly plays mean, the new firm would choose to stay out. Now given that the monopoly plays nice, we're looking at the right column, the new firm would choose to enter because entering will give $2 million profit to the new firm. And 2 is better than 0, so we would choose to enter if the monopoly plays nice. Now, how would the monopoly choose? So given that the new firm chooses to stay out, we can see that monopoly is indifferent between being mean and being nice. So I'm going to double blind those of this payoff. So 10 is the same as 10, so I don't have a preference. Given the new firm chooses to enter, the monopoly will choose to play nice because 5 is better than negative 1. So I'm going to underline here. Now you can see we have two Nash equilibria. One is that the new firm chooses to stay out and the monopoly plays mean. Or the new firm chooses to enter and the monopoly plays nice. So this are both Nash equilibria, and it makes sense. Think about this. If the monopoly threatens ahead, I'm going to be really, really mean. Then the new friend will be like, I don't want to suffer a loss. I want to stay out. But if the monopoly says, I'm going to be nice if you enter, then the new friend will feel free to enter. So these are both Nash equilibria. But notice that one equilibrium doesn't really make sense. That is this one. And if you solve the sequential game using backward induction, then you're going to get a refinement of Nash equilibrium that's called subgame perfect equilibrium. So we're going to use backward induction to see how we solve the game. So suppose we're here. We're going to start for the last node, this one. So suppose we're already here. Then the monopoly see that the new firm already entered. What would it do? So the monopoly would say, hey, if I play mean, I'm going to suffer $1 million loss. If I play nice, I can get $5 million profit. So 5 is better than -1. So the monopoly would be like, if you enter, I'm going to play nice because I'm not going to shoot my own foot playing mean and get -1. That's not what I'm going to do. And the new firm knows that, hey, if I enter, that's where we're going. So I don't have to worry about monopoly being mean to me because I know the monopoly is not going to shoot his own foot. So given that monopoly is going to be nice, then I'm going to look at this. I'm not going to worry about that anymore because that's not where we're going. So the new friend was saying, hey, if I stay out, I'm going to get 0 for sure. And if I enter, I know that monopoly is going to play nice because monopoly is not going to shoot its own foot. So if I enter, the monopoly will play nice and I'm going to get 2. So 2 is better than 0. So I will prefer to enter the market. So you can see that using backward induction, we have only one subgame perfect equilibrium in this game. That is the new firm is going to enter and the existing monopoly is going to play nice. So you can see, even though we have two Nash equilibria in here, that is the new firm stays out and monopoly plays mean, and the new firm enters and the monopoly plays nice, but only one equilibrium makes sense. That is the subgame perfect equilibrium where the new firm enters and monopoly plays nice. Why? Because we say this, you know what? The threat that the monopoly says I'm going to play mean is actually a non-credible threat. Meaning, because if you choose this, then you're going to shoot your own foot. So we don't have to believe that. We call that non-credible threat. So this is subgame perfect equilibrium and how to use backward induction to find subgame perfect equilibrium. And also, you solve the game using the payoff matrix. That way you'll be able to find all Nash equilibria. But notice that in this game, only one Nash is subgame perfect. And that's this one. The new firm enters and the monopoly plays nice. I hope this helps, and I'll see you next time.